Hello, and welcome back to fun Halloween project spooky time. We are pulling out the Sculpey again because I never learn. No, but actually, it's just fun to play around with, even if I'm not great at it. And I break it every single time. We are making a fun little decoration that, unlike last year's spider candle holder, is actually designed to be a candle holder. The plan is to sculpt a little tentacle to wrap around a candle and have it come out of a picture frame so you can hang it on a wall like the one behind me. This is all going to be on a tiny scale though, because I don't trust Sculpey and I have these cute little candles that are meant to be like spell candles, but I just use them as alternatives to tea lights since I found a tiny little candle holder at an op shop and then I obsessively went looking for candles that were 1.5 centimeters thick. They burn for like 2 hours, it's great. My candle preferences aside, let's just jump on in. To begin, I made a bakeable candle from a dowel rod and foil and made a frame backing for the tentacle to screw onto. The main sculpt was pretty simple. I made a long tapering tube for the tentacle, attached it to the base screw, and then wrapped it around the dowel rod. To make suckers, I rolled out little balls and then used a round-headed sculpting tool to poke them into the tentacle. Use rubbing alcohol to carefully smooth out your sculpting and take away any rough edges. Once baked, you can carefully remove the dowel rod and foil. I mixed a dark purple for the base coat and slathered it all over the tentacle, focusing on the areas that would be visible when the candle was in place. I used my favorite Gnome Oil shade paint to darken up the nooks and crannies. I then dry brushed on a few layers of light purples to give some dimension, focusing on the suckers and the top curve of the tentacle. I used black velvet for the backing, cutting a hole for the screw to poke through and gluing it down with Mod Podge. Pop it all into place using a bit of glue to make sure the tentacle is secure and in an upright position. The finishing touch was to add some clear nail polish for shine. I am thrilled with how this little guy turned out. It's super heckin' cool. I did the nail polish glaze at the advice of my partner, and I think it just adds that real sea life feel, like it's wet or slimy or just kind of creepy. It doesn't have to be like a tentacle as far as a kraken. It can be like, I don't know, an eldritchy tentacle thing. Cthulhu's beard. If you've seen pretty much every other Sculpey video I've done, you won't be surprised to learn that it cracked when I was screwing it on, which is my fault because I went too far, but I did see it when I was editing the making footage and that it has a small fissure at that point after baking, and I just made it worse. I imagine this is going to be horrible to try and clean wax off of, and I don't think I should let the flame burn the Sculpey paint or nail polish. So I might need to create like a little booster to keep the candle flame above the tentacle, or maybe even make an LED candle for it or something. Despite the clear safety flaws, I am very happy with how it turned out. That is it for this project. I am posting more videos throughout October for this fun Halloween project spooky time. So hit the subscribe button and the notification bell if you want to keep up to date, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!